Hey guys, so I decided to go ahead and record the first part of my story, basically, since I already have my suicide story up, but because I just transferred that one, I decided to go ahead and do technically two this week. So I'm here with Tiger. He hasn't been feeling good, so I've been cuddling with him. He's been sick for about 2 weeks. But, so the first part is I'm basically going to go ahead and start from the beginning. So, this part will mainly be about my real father, because in the beginning, it was about him. And that's kind of where my low self-esteem came in from. So, after I was born, he literally took off. He was gone. And so, my mom had my stepdad, and my stepdad accepted me and stuff. But when I was one, my real father came back into my life and would take me for, like, holidays and stuff, so, I don't really remember that time in my life. I just know what I heard from people, so I don't really discuss it because I really don't know what is true and what is not, so, but I do know when I was 3 years old, I received a call from him saying, "Hey, I'm going to come pick you up." And being a three-year-old, I got really excited. I'm like, "Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, my father's coming to get me, and it's going to be so much fun." So being three, I grabbed my little chair, and I decided to sit and stare out the window waiting for him to show up. And I had the phone right next to me, and I was so excited. And I sat there literally all day long until my mom told me to go to bed. And I just sat there. And it really, being 3 years old, it affected me greatly. Like, that was crushing. But of course, being three, of course, I'm like, "Oh, well, something must have happened, you know." You know, so, but as I got older, like, seriously, he never really was a part of it, my life, because in all reality, he abandoned me on that day, and for the longest time, I never even heard from him. So, basically, my mom and my stepdad raised me, and to my mom, my stepdad is my father, and so I was never allowed to call him my stepdad. I would get yelled at and told that that's not true, he's not your stepfather, he is your real father. But as I got older, I'm like, well, sure, he raised me and stuff, so yeah, technically he's more my real father than my father is, but still, you know, my real father, he's not my real father. He did not, you know, make me, so, you know, and as I grew up, you know, my real father, he did some dumb stuff, and he, a lot of times, ended up in the hospital where we thought he wasn't going to make it. And so when I got those calls or those Facebook messages saying, you know, he's in the hospital, he might not make it, could come up and see him and say goodbyes, you know, my mom got pissed at me because I would ask and want to go up there, and I didn't understand why it was so wrong to want to go up there. I knew he wasn't in my life, and it wasn't about that. He was still my father. And, you know, so, growing up, I thought it was wrong of me. I was wrong because I still considered my real father, and I considered my stepdad as my stepdad. And that's hard as a child growing up, because, like, how do you, I don't know how to describe it, but, even though I never really saw him, I did see that side of the family, and I grew really close to two of my aunts, and of course some of my cousins, but, you know, I grew close to them, and I remember one day, I was over at that side of the family, one of my aunt's house, and I received a call from my brother telling me if I did not come outside, well, it was my half brother, so my stepdad's kid, my stepdad and my mom's kid, if I did not come outside, he was gonna come in there and drag me out by my hair. And I looked at my aunts and I begged them, please don't let him do this. And they said, you know, we're not going to allow that. You wanted to come over, you wanted to hang out. And so I did feel like I was in the wrong, just because I still wanted a relationship with them. And as a child, it's not right to do that. Like, you're basically telling me I'm stupid or whatever because I want a relationship with that side of the family, and it's just not true, you know? They are my family, and I will love them just as I love everybody else. You know, I don't hate against anybody, no matter what the hell heck you do to me, I still can't hate you. And so, that's just part of the story. So that's basically what happened with my father, and sadly, one of the aunts I grew very close to died because she was into drugs, and her and her husband did some bad heroin, and she ended up dying, and her husband almost died. And so, you know, I looked at my life, and I looked at theirs, and I realized, yeah, they're not the best role models. And so, you know, I still love them, and no matter what they do, I'll still try to be a part of their lives, and that's just how I feel. You know, I'm not gonna, the only time I will literally close you out of my life is if you, if you start attacking me because of what I am or who I am, then basically I will shut you out of my life, because I don't want to feel like I'm some terrible person because of who I like, who I love, what sexuality I am, or because of stuff I do. And so, yeah, so that's this part. Next week I will do my growing up part story, which has a lot of issues in it. So, alright guys, bye, until next time.